zu seinem Event Marduk. Hello.
Hello.
We are from the Offener Kanal, that's a cable TV station of Berlin. And we want to ask some questions to you. First, your last tour in Berlin, you were with Immortal, and in our mind, Marduk was more successful than Immortal. Did you have problems with Immortal in this time?
No, no. We got along really well with Immortal, since we know them since a long time back. And they're great friends of ours. It was an honor to tour with them. And the Sons of Northern Darkness tour was a great success for both bands. And Immortal is a supreme band.
Yeah, that's correct.
Okay. Your label is Osmose Records. And in our mind, the most publicity is by is done by Osmose for the group MPAT Nazarene. Do we have problems with Osmose?
No, we have no problems with Osmose. I think that Osmose has done a good work so far. But of course, things can always get better, and I hope they will be in the future. But I would say we are quite satisfied so far. Osmose is the best label for us, I guess. I cannot think of any label for our music and our ideas and everything. They suit us perfect.
Are you in contact with other Swedish black metal bands?
Oh yeah, we are in contact with most of the Swedish black metal bands that have existed for a while. We're not in contact with many of the new ones, but the older ones, yes. I would say so.
What kind of music do you prefer in private?
In private? I listen to those black metal bands that give me something special, those who have something to offer, originality and supreme brutality. I also listen to some old metal like Iron Maiden and stuff. And also some, atmospheric music, some electronic stuff, but mostly it's extreme metal.
Mm-hmm. And you?
Classical music and the same.
Yeah.
Hey. Okay, now is Ingrid.
On those of the Unlight, there's an instrumental called Echoes from the Past.
Yeah.
And it seems a rather soft, almost romantic piece. And it has nothing to do with the aggression and hatred, which is normally found in black metal. Maybe you would like to say what symbolizes these echoes?
Yeah, first of all, Marduk is, it's basically based, Marduk is based on aggressivity and hate. But that track, Echoes from the Past, is more of a thought of the past, you can say, in the north or something. It's just, I had an idea. That track is written by an old guitarist who we fired a time ago. He had done that track back in 86, 87, and we were out driving a car out somewhere in some forest, and I just got to think of that track, and we just decided to do it for the album.
I see.
But it's quite different.
It is.
Divo Anderson had to leave the band. Is the reason for that that maybe the music is too different from the style what you are playing?
The old guitarist.
Yeah, with the Overflesh project.
Yeah. Well, we were not too satisfied with him both as a guitarist and as a person, and we don't like that project, Overflesh, so we decided just to fire him. And since that, everything has become a lot better in the band.
On those of the Unlight, there are no lyrics included. As you said, there was no time to include them. But they will be obtainable for the new Opus Nocturne. Do you not think that it could get into the wrong hands and shouldn't be published?
No, I don't think. The reason for that we haven't used the lyrics so far is basically because of problems in the last minute with layout and stuff. So we have decided now to make some kind of a booklet that Osmose Productions will fix with all our three albums. All the lyrics with a complete biography should be released very soon. We're going to work on that when we come home from the tour.
Let me play the Advocatus Diabolo. I don't think that black metal bands should play at all in public, outside their own circle. What is the reason for you to play in a large public where there could be danger of misinterpretation and commonization?
Well, I don't know really. We just do it. We're spreading a message. We're spreading our music. Why not? I don't know really.
You're not afraid that it gets into the wrong hands?
In the wrong hands, you know, you can never control anything. It will always get in the hands of people that don't have to do with it. That's just the way it is. You can't stop it.
Well, to change the subject, your new album, maybe you want to tell us about it?
It's called Opus Nocturne, and it's 9 tracks, and it was recorded in September 94 and released in December, and it's, you can say, a further progression from those of the Unlight. It's we have a new drummer that is a lot better than the old one, and we also fired that guitarist, so I play all the guitars on the album. It's faster, it's darker, and it's more extreme, basically.
It's the third concert on your tour, I think, so far. How is the tour going?
It's going okay. We have just played in Austria, and we're playing our fourth German show today, so we have not really done so much yet. So it's very hard to speak of it at the moment.
Mm. Fine. So thank you, and I wish you good luck for the concert tonight.
Thanks.